Hello students, good morning to all. So today we will continue our discussion of lesson 3, basic HTML elements. And today I will show you practically that how to create a web page. So see, first of all, for writing the HTML code, yesterday I have explained you that we have to open a editor, text editor. So like the notepad or wordpad. So in my laptop there is the notepad. So I am going to open the, type in the search box notepad. Okay, so see the notepad is open. So I'll click on this notepad. Now the notepad will open. So this is the text editor. So now on this text editor we have to write the HTML code. So the basic structure I have explained you yesterday, that the HTML tag should be open. So the HTML is a container tag. Now see the HTML inside the angular bracket we are writing, this is the call tag. So whatever the things you write, whatever the text you write inside the angular bracket open and close, that is called a tag. So that's why HTML is called a tag based language. So HTML open. Now it's a close is also needed. So we'll close this HTML. We'll close this HTML. Okay. Now after that, inside the HTML there is a head tag. We use the head tag for giving the title of the web page. So we'll open the head tag, and inside the head there is a title tag. So we open the title tag. And the title for the web page we have to set. So suppose here today we are going to learn about the nested list. Okay, so here we'll write the nested list. Nested list. Okay, this is the title of the web page will be set. Now I will close the title tag. We'll close the title tag, and after that we have to close the head tag. Okay, now see the head tag is closed. So head close, and the title for the web page we have said nested list, and after that we open the body tag. So where inside the body tag we write all the text which we want to present on the web page. Now yesterday I have taught you that every web page has two sections. Every HTML code has two sections, header section and body section. Now header section we completed. Header section encloses the title bar, means to set the title of the web page. Now body section will enclose all the text which you want to present on the web page. So here we will open the body tag. Now body tag has the various attributes. So here you are seeing, first of all I am not using any attribute inside the body, so let me simply now this body open, and on the next line I will close this body tag. Now this is the close of the body, is a container tag, so that's why I have closed it. Now all the commands I will write it here inside the body tag. Okay, so now we want to create a here a ordered list. Okay, so first of all I want to set the color of the text on the web page, that is some blue color. Or so for that we use the font tag. We are using the, for the changing the color and appearance of the text on the web page, we use the font tag. So here we open the font. Okay, and you can use the face equals to. So the values, face is the attribute, and values we write inside the double inverted comma. So the face we can here we can use, many face are there. So I am going to use the Lucida handwriting. Okay. So and after that we can use its size, and size we have to give in terms of pixel. So size is the attribute equals to, and you can we can set the size 15. Now color, what is the color of the text? So color equals to, and that also you can specify in the double inverted comma its color name. So color here we are using blue. Okay, now font is set. Now after that we will close the font tag. Font is also a container tag, so I have to close it. Now see here, the font tag I have closed. Now whatever we write between this font open and close, whatever the things we write, that will appear in color, blue color, and size will be 15 pixel, and the style will be the Lucida handwriting. Okay, now we have to create here a list. So what I am going to write, example of nested list, example of nested knit. Here we use the B tag, this is called the bold tag. So inside the bold, B for bold, and here we close the bold tag. Okay, now inside this bold tag we will write examples of nested list. So what we write, we can write examples of nested list, nested list. Okay, so now we create a list. So first list we create the ordered list. So to unordered list, ordered list and unordered list. So ordered list means there is a numbering 1 2 3 4. So if the sequence, if the if you want to give the priority to the numbering on the each item of the list, so we use the order list. Means if order, if position is important to display in the list, so we use the order list. So order list is created with the help of the OL tag. So I will open the OL tag. This is the OL tag. Now here in the OL we have to use the attribute. We are using the attribute type. So which types of the ordering you wants to use it here. Okay, so by default if you not specify any type, it will take the numbers 1 2 3 4. Okay, so here first of all I am not using any numbering. By default it will take the 1 2 3 4, but if we use the here type attribute. Now we'll open and we'll close the OL tag, because order list is also a container tag. So whatever we write inside this OL tag, that will appear as a ordered list numbering format. So now I will write the first order list item is the input devices, first item of the order list here. So this, the item of the order list or unordered list, both are written with the li tag. But how we are writing? With the help of the li tag. So I will write the li list of items. Here li means list item, li meaning is the list of item. So first, this is li tag is an empty tag, its close is not needed. So first item, list item of the first ordered list item is the input devices. So I am going to write the input devices that I have written in the ordered list. Now nesting means inside this ordered list we wants to create the unordered list. So after that I will write the UL tag. So to create the unordered list, we use the UL tag. What we are using? UL tag. So here the type attribute we use, by default it will take the disk. By default it will take the disk, bullet symbol. Type is the attribute and value we pass the bullet name. So here different types of bullets are there, square, circle, disk. So here we are going to use the circle. CIRCLE. Suppose I have used the circle. Okay, UL type we have given circle. Now we'll close the UL tag because it is a container tag, so its close is needed. So we'll close it. UL is closed. Now the list of items we write with the help of the li tag here in the unordered list. What list of items we are going to use? Okay, so here the list of items, we'll write it here inside this li with the help of the li tag. So first item of the unordered list is the here input devices. Write the keyboard. Keyboard is the input device. So what I am going to write the keyboard. Okay. So next list of item will write mouse. So this HTML is the case insensitive language. So whether you are writing the capital letter, small letter, it doesn't matter. You will get the same output. Okay, so two unordered list I have prepared here. Now another after that we go in the ordered list. So second item of the ordered list. See, after the UL closed, I am writing the second item of the ordered list. So that is the second item of the ordered list is the output devices. What I am going to write the output devices. See. Yes, output devices. So I am writing the output devices. This is the second item of the ordered list. Now again I will use the unordered list in this. So here the same thing, I will copy it. Some values are there, Ctrl plus C, copy. And here I will paste it. Okay, so here the type circle I have used on this place. Now this time I will use the disk. Disk or square I am using this time. SQUARE. SQU square. Okay, UL type equals to square I am using here. This I have not closed my. There is a mistake. And here also angular bracket closed. So here the item for the output devices on the place of keyboard I have to write some other thing, monitor or printer I will write. So monitor and the second list of item with a printer. Printer, okay. So I have written these things. So now we'll save this file. Now the HTML code we have written, see, in the proper format. Now we have to save this file. So click go on the file, there is a save. Ctrl plus S, save it. So it will ask the file name. Now see here, it has asked the file name. So this is, I will write the nested list, the name of the file. What a nested. Already is there, nested list dot HTML. So here nested I will write only, nested dot extension. What you have to use, HTML. Don't forget to write this extension, HTML. And file name I have given nested.html. Here it is written save as type. All files, no problem. Now where I want to save, I want to save this on my desktop. So I am setting the location desktop here. Now I will save it on the desktop, nested.html. See, you just save desktop nested.html. You don't have the permission to save in this location. So I don't have the permission to save in this location. Would you like to save in the document folder instead? Okay, so I don't have the permission to save on the desktop. It is protected in my computer only. Okay, so some in the document I will save it. File name nested dot HTML. Now I will save it. Now it is saved. After that, what we have to do? After that, we search that file. Here in the search box, you type the nested. Your file name nested. Now see, nested is appear. So you this file, so you make a double click, so that will be open in the Mozilla Firefox browser. With the help of this browser, this will be open. So browser, Mozilla Firefox will run that HTML code and make a web page for me. Now see, let me make a double click on it. Now see, it will execute that HTML file. see examples of nested list. As you can see, that is the output, that is the ordered list input, and this is the circle and this is the square bullet which we have used. Okay, now let me show you the code here. Here again we are going to make some changes. Okay, so that the second color we want to change this output devices, here we use the font tag again, and here we use some different font color. So what we write, font we write it just font. Okay, font, here we use some other face equals to double quotation mark, we write the face times New Roman times New Roman. Okay, size, this time size we will set 10, and color, this time color I will set some undervalued comma. This time color we are going to set a red color. Now I will save it, and again I will refresh this my web page. So by clicking here you can refresh it, and you see the color is changed. Okay, output devices, monitor, printer. Now another thing I will show you in my code. Again I will open my the HTML file, see, and here the background color of the web page, as you can see, is white. Now this background I want to give some color. So the background color I am going to set the peach off. So let me open this file here inside the body tag. To set the background color of the web page, we use the attribute bg color. So what I will write, bg color, bg color equals to double quotation mark, we write each of each of. Okay, so that is the color, background color. Now let me save this again, control plus s, I will save it, and I will refresh this web page by clicking on this or by pressing the F5 button. Also you can do the same task. Okay, so let me refresh it. Just so this peach puff color, maybe it is not supporting by this Firefox browser. Let me change some other color on the place of peach puff. So bh color, sorry, written wrong command, written bg color. It should be the bg color. Control plus s, so we save it, bg color. Now we'll refresh it and see the changes. Yes, now it is changed. So this is the peach puff background color of the web page. You can see now it is changed. So with the help of the which attribute, bg color. Okay. So how we create this ordered list and unordered list is the numbering what you are seeing here, 1 and 2, that is the ordered list. So in the output devices, 2 is not appearing here. So see in the code, ordered ol, yes. Now you will close. Now again we have written the li, list of item, output devices. Now its ul is not closed. Here ul open, but ul I haven't closed, so that's why this problem is occurring here. So I have to close the ul tag. Ul tag is not closed. Now this time I will save it. Now you will see the, press the F5. Refresh it. Here this ul tag equals to square. Li monitor, li printer, and you will close. Order list is also closed here. Font is at the end. Share font. I haven't closed the font tag, so let me close that font tag also. Close the font. So first you save this file. Yes, already saved. Refresh it. Let me close this. So now next time I will open this file with the help of the Google Chrome browser. So what I have to do, I will go on this PC, I will search in the document my HTML file. So in the document, see, I will get the nested file. So here in the document, I will get the nested.html which I have saved. See, this is the nested. So that I will select this file, make a right click, a context menu will open. Now here I will get the option, see the open with. So again a context menu will open. Here I will select the browser, Google Chrome this time. Sometimes some command is not supported by the some browser, because here for executing or running the HTML file, we need the latest browser. Now see the Chrome is executing that HTML file. Now see, here you are getting the output. Okay, so you can see it's a source code it also here by making a right click and you view base source. So here on the same page you can see it's a source code also. Okay, so this is a source code. How many codes are there? 23 line of codes are there written. So let me open this notepad file. As you can now, I'm going to explain you. Here see the body tag, body section. Inside the body section, I've used the font face Lucida handwriting, size 15, color blue. Now bold tag to set the list text examples of nested list in the bold. Now order list, input devices, list of item. Now unordered list inside the order. UL type goes to circle here. List of item is now UL is closed. Now again we are using the li for the list of output devices. So it should be now after this li output devices another unordered list we have opened, type equals to square and unordered list close, and here the ordered list is close. So with the help of the li tag, it is empty tag, we are listing the items of the list. Now after this, here font open and font closed, size 10, color red we have set. Okay, now font close here. This font which we are closing here, so let me close this font, Ctrl X, cut it, and it should close here. Ctrl V, paste it. Now we save it. Now we refresh this page. Okay, now you can see its numbering, examples of nested list, input devices, output devices. So like this, students, we create the ordered list and unordered list which I have shown you. Now some other tags also I will show you how to draw a horizontal line and other thing. So if suppose you want to draw a horizontal line, we use the HR tag. One tag I have shown you. To change the line, we are using the BR tag. To write a paragraph, we are using the P tag. So I have already written HTML file. So let me open that and I will show you its output. Okay. So see, so many files I have already, one nested list is there, which is already prepared. So I will open this with the help of the another browser this time. Internet Explorer, I will. I have a nested list previously. Now see, this is the nested list. So this I will show you the same thing, see, the nested list again, and I will show you its source code also. So here I will make a right click. Make a right click. Open with Internet Explorer. Okay. Now make a right click, here you find. Okay, no problem. So now I will open this in the notepad also. I will show you its code. So open with notepad, I have to select open with notepad. I will show you the source code of this, you can see. The which list I have shown you, this one, sorry, not this, this one, Internet Explorer. This list or source code is this. See, the body background color is set green. You are seeing the top margin is set. Top margin is also the attribute of the body tag. To set the 50 pixel space from the top, that is called the top margin. Text is yellow. So all the text, if you text is the attribute of the body tag, text yellow means the all the texts on the web page will appear in the yellow color. As you can see here, all the text is in the yellow color. This is due to text yellow, which I have written. Left margin 60 pixel HR. Horizontal, draw a horizontal right line. We use the HR tag. Size I set 10 pixel. That is the thickness of the line, and with 250, that is the length of the line. Color red and no shade. This is all the attribute of the HR tag. You can see on this web page, this is the line. So if I will change its width from 250, if I will make it 500, its length will increase. You can see 500 I have made. Control plus S, save it, and I will refresh this page. Here, and I will refresh it, and you will find. So I have to open it again. Here, refresh option is there. Now see, its width is increased automatically. Okay. So color red here I have written. Now H1 is used to give the heading. There are six different heading labels in the HTML. H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. H1 is the biggest heading level. As you increase the number, the heading size means that is the height of the letters will decrease. Heading size will decrease. So H6 is the lowest heading. So here see, I have written inside the heading. Align is the attribute of the H1 tag. So text will be center. What I written, nested list in HTML. So see on the web page, nested list in HTML, this is the heading H1. So if I will write the H4 heading here, you see its size will decrease. Here on the place of H1, now I am writing, see here, H4. And since this is a container tag, here also I have to write the H4. Now I will save it and refresh it, and you will see the changes. Refresh it. Here see, now see its size is decreased. So H1 is the biggest heading level, which I told you. So here again we go, and I will write H1. H1 is the biggest heading level. H1 is the biggest heading label. So what we write H1 again, I will save it, and you will see its size will increase. Refresh it. Now see increase. Okay. So after that, the comment is used For whatever the thing we will write inside the comment tag here, this text will not be displayed in the browser. As you can see, after this nested list, this text will not appear. So angular bracket open, exclamation mark and double hyphen symbol, and double hyphen angular bracket close. So whatever the thing you write inside this, this is called the comment. So that will not appear on the web page. You see, that text is not written here. But here what is written in the your HTML code, this text will not be displayed in the browser. Yes, it is not displaying. You can also use the comment open and close. See, if I am writing here the paragraph, align right, Anu Pratap, so that will not appear because you have it inside the comment tag. That also you cannot see on the web page. But see, when I will remove this comment tag, if suppose I am removing it, so that text will appear. Now it will appear what I have written. This is the paragraph tag. So paragraph, if you want to write a big line of text, so we use the paragraph. For long text, we are using the paragraph tag P. Now I will save it and refresh the web page. You will find the text. See here. Now see, alignment is right. So if I will make it alignment or center, four values we can pass, left, right, center. So I am writing the alignment or center. Center, okay. Now I will save it and refresh it. You will find the text which is on the right. Now it will come on the center. Now see, it is appearing in the center. Okay, after that, font size I have set 16 face Arial, order list type equals to 1. See, in the list I have given. Now UL tag open, list of items of the UL tag, UL close. Now list of item good qualities, that is the second list. UL type square, list increases. Okay, like this. Now OL close. So inside the OL we have used two times the unordered list, one time here and one time here. Now you can see on the, this is the list. Okay. So now I will show you some other tags also. Bold tag, italic tag, underline tag, other tags are also there. So let me open some another HTML file and in that I will show you. Let me close this one. So any other HTML file is there? Yes, that is the spanning is there. Table, that is not in the in the next chapter. So some spanning is there. Another nested list is there. Yes, another list is there. Drop form is there, distributed. So B1, B2. Let me open this B1 file. Make a double click, it will open with some browser. By default, it will open in the Mozilla Firefox, because by default the browser is set Mozilla Firefox. Now see what is written in the B1. See here. So some chemical formula and carbon dioxide, all these things. So this is the important. So I will show you how to write this. So let me open the same file in the notepad. Then you will be able to understand. Open with notepad. Now see. Here, background color of the web page I have set aqualine. And the image also set in the background. We use the background attribute to set the image. Some WhatsApp image I have set, as you have seen, the WhatsApp image. Some image is set, so that I will show you the image also. Okay, top margin 50 pixel, horizontal line is used, size 10. H1 heading, text will display in the browser. Now H2 align right, use chemical and mathematical formula. So see, H2 second heading label, using chemical and mathematical formula, alignment is set right. Now this chemical formula, how it is written, carbon dioxide. Now you can see CO2, how you will write. Now CO, for writing 2 as a subscript place means if you are writing at the two at the bottom of the text, that is called the subscript. So for that we are using the sub tag sub to co, and after that sub open to sub close. Br is used for changing the line. Here br is used to change the line. After chemical formula, one there will be the one line space co and two. Mathematical formula we are writing a plus b whole square. For writing the any number over the text, we use a superscript tag. This is the SUP, superscript. So SUP 2 and SUP close. Now A square, A SUP 2, A square plus B square, B SUP 2, SUP close plus 2AB. Now you can see on the web page this formula. A plus B whole square equals to A square plus B square plus 2AB. Let me increase its size, font size, then it will be very nice to see. So here what I have written this entire thing, let me here open the font tag, and I am writing font, and its a size I am going to size equals to, I will write 30 pixels. Okay, 30 written. Now I will close the font here. Close the font. Now I will save it and refresh this page. Now you will see the changes. Size will increase. Now you can see its size is increased in the critical formula. A plus B whole square, A square plus B square. So this A square, how we have written A, and after that we have written SUP tag open 2 and SUP tag close. As you can see on this, yes. A SUP tag open 2. So this is called the superscript tag. So like this, the questions is will also ask in the exam. You have to write this type of the formula. So practice well at home. Such type of programs is important. So next is this chemical formula. Let me increase the size of this also, chemical formula. So where I have written this font size. So let me, font size 30, I have written it here. Let me cut and paste it here, where I have written the chemical formula. Okay. Now it will also appear. Now let me save it. And again I will refresh it. So see, chemical formula size is also CO2. So this 2 is written at below the letter O, that is called the subscript. This is in the subscript position. Okay. Now this paragraph aligned right, Amitabh is written, font size. So all these are the different tags that we have completed. The syllabus also, all the attributes also we have studied, ordered list, unordered list, and some character entities is left, which also I will teach you, and to leave the number of blank spaces. Okay, background color, active link, and other things. So what is the remaining that I will teach you in the next class? Some other practicals. Here the bold tag, italic tag, meta tag, other things are also there. So this is all for the today's students. Thank you for your kind attention.